Happy Halloween, everybody. It wasn't 10 minutes after I finished my video from yesterday about the iPhone 12 Pro just being way too large a form factor for this style and design of phone. Not 10 minutes later did UPS ring my doorbell and drop this phone off, the Palm. Now, about a year ago, I did a review about a really tiny phone called the Light Phone that has e-ink and actually, I'm gonna go grab it real quick, one sec. So give or take a year ago, I did a review about this phone. It's called the Light Phone. It is very lightweight and it has e-ink and can actually piggyback off the cell phone plan from like your main cell phone line for, at least with T-Mobile, about 10 bucks a month. To add this on, you get very basic rudimentary text messaging, phone call placements, and that's about it. They did just issue an update so that you could do podcasts and music. But it's a fairly limited phone, which was the appeal and continues to be the appeal of the Light Phone. It's a great little device. But for me, the big reason I still feel that hesitation to leave the house completely without my big, you know, soul-sucking iPhone is because of maps. I really just never want to have to be printing directions ever again or ever feel like I'm lost. And honestly, over the last decade or so, I've become a fairly poor navigator just because I have had my phone as a crutch for so long. So the first thing that caught my attention about this Palm phone immediately is that it runs a full version of Android. I'm not sure which version. I've never owned, I have owned one Android phone, but I've never used it as sort of my daily driver. Palm brands this phone as your new tiny sidekick for when you want to escape from your big phone. So that sounds about right to me. The phone is for sale for $279, so I figured I would just go for it, see how it works, return it if I don't use it. Even though I didn't end up using the Light Phone that much over the past year, it was really nice to throw it in my bag for a wedding, you know, just as a backup phone. That's one reason I love the Apple Watch so much, is as a wedding photographer, I have a nice backup when it comes to data. And I never miss messages from my second shooters. You know, I love, love, love my Apple Watch. But it's still not quite the disconnect I'm looking for from the iPhone. I mean, when the Apple Watch first came out, that was sort of the fantasy, is that it would enable less screen time. I find the Apple Watch to be a pretty critical part of my life now, but certainly doesn't make me feel like I can totally disconnect from my phone for a full day or something. God, I sound like such an addict. Okay, so unboxing this, I'm gonna admit I already opened this, and to be honest, I think unboxings are kind of lame. I've tried a few of them, and it's like, what? This is stupid. So I already have the phone right here. This is it. It is literally palm-sized. To give you a sense of the actual size, if you've got an iPhone SE, which I think is the same size as the old iPhone 5, the Palm phone is so small that it is actually the footprint, roughly, of just the screen of the iPhone SE. That's really small. And it's super thin. In fact, it's more thin than the iPhone SE. It's got the rounded corners. And I just wanna compare this to the newest iPhone size. I mean, you could probably fit two of them in there if you could cut the palm up. The other big thing I forgot to mention, with the Light Phone, there's no camera. And there is a decent camera with the Palm. I mean, you're not gonna get iPhone quality and you're certainly not gonna be approaching RAW or portrait mode or anything fancy like that. But for a quick snapshot of something you don't wanna forget about, this is absolutely great. I love it. And it's even got a front-facing camera for Face ID if you want, which is crazy. I've never kind of lived with a daily driver of an Android phone. For any phone I've ever tested, I've always kind of had an issue with the scrolling. It's still just not nearly as fluid or as natural as Apple has figured out, but it's not bad. And it's certainly usable for a device this size. Regardless, it comes pre-installed with the full suite of Google apps, Google Maps, Gmail, of course, the Play Store, so you can add any of your apps you'd like to. But what I'm realizing, even with some of the more addictive apps like Reddit or Instagram that I'm putting on here, I find the desire and the pull to the screen to be far, far less intense, simply because it's not as comfortable a viewing experience. I'm not sitting here squinting, but you know, the giant iPhone screens just make it a few shades too easy to look at and digest and scroll through. It's a nice experience, don't get me wrong, but it's a little too nice. This still provides all the core functionality you could possibly want if you need it, or if you're just incredibly bored or whatever. But again, it's just so small. It's in my pocket and I forget I even have it. It's not vying for my attention unless you crank up the volume or something like that. So I paired my Apple AirPods over Bluetooth to this. I have Spotify on there, so I'm good to go with music. I've got Apple Maps. It's incredibly lightweight. It's really well built. It feels solid. And even it's so light that even if it didn't feel solid, the dropping it feels, I don't know how to describe the weight. It's a featherweight. That's all I can say. Very, very impressed with this. I don't know that much about the company. It came with a SIM card with US Mobile, which I think piggybacks off one of the other major three carriers. Free month of LTE data. Oh, the other big thing that I really, really love, even after only owning this for an afternoon and plugging it in a few times to try charging, the USB-C on the back. I can't believe the iPhone hasn't gone USB-C yet, like the iPad Pro. The battery life, again, I haven't kept it very long. I'm sure the battery life isn't fantastic, but right now it seems fine. They sell like a battery booster or something like that. Even with a case, this thing is certainly manageable in terms of size and comfort. If you were considering the Lite phone, this does have exceptional battery life, by the way. This is an e-ink screen, so it'll last for days. But if you're considering the Lite phone and your everyday life is just sort of positioned around having access to the internet in some way, the Palm phone seems to be great. And it couldn't have come for a better time for me personally, pushing back against the size creep that Apple is implementing with all of their larger and larger phones that is just becoming less and less appealing to me over time. So I'm gonna keep my iPhone 11 Pro. I'm still gonna try the 12 mini. I just wanted to make a video expressing that. I got a lot of messages when I showed the picture on my Instagram stories with this in my hand. Seems like a great little device, really thoughtfully designed, and Android isn't as bad as I thought. So as always, thank you so much for your attention. Have a great Halloween. Bye.